with the goal of educating those far inland from the northern Gulf Coast about the dangers of rip currents, the National Weather Service offices in Mobile and Tallahassee are observing the 4th annual Rip Current Awareness Week now through March 1st. Today is day one, and the topic is all about rip currents. Spring break season is approaching, and the vast majority of rip current fatalities involve non-residents on vacation from the Tennessee Valley and Deep South. We know that the Gulf Coast is known for its beaches, but rip currents are a hidden danger that visitors and locals should be aware of. Some may believe that the Gulf is always calm with no surf, but in reality, there are a variety of conditions that can bring big waves to the area and an increased threat for rip currents. A rip current is a narrow channel of water flowing away from the beach. They typically extend from near the shoreline out through the breaker zone where breaking waves form. They also commonly form around breaks in sandbars and near inlets, jetties, and piers. A rip current is not the same as a riptide, nor are they the same as an undertow. Rip currents do not pull you underwater, they just pull you away from the shore. You can think of a rip current as a natural treadmill traveling away from the beach. They can travel as fast as 8 feet per second. That is faster than an Olympic swimmer. Rip currents are dangerous because it can sweep even the strongest swimmers out to sea. For that reason, rip currents are life-threatening to anyone entering the water. Rip currents are the number one weather-related killer at beaches along the northern Gulf Coast. Since 2002, there have been 213 rip current fatalities in the beaches covered by the National Weather Service offices in Mobile and Tallahassee. That number is more than the fatalities of flooding, tornadoes, lightning, and tropical systems combined. So, just because you come to the beach to have fun, that does not mean you can forget about safety. Thanks for spending a minute with EM.